Hi guys, welcome to Artists Insider. My name's Fieldy, I'm a professional artist, and this series is meant to be like an informal, low-key chat with you guys to give you the inside down low on being an artist and running an arts business. Are you ready to take your art career to the next level? If you are, come check out Fieldy's Art Academy All Access Membership. It's for artists just like you who are wanting to turn their art hobby into a thriving, profitable art career. It's only $49 a month, and when you sign up, you're gonna get access to all of my exclusive online art courses, plus monthly group coaching sessions with me, where you can ask questions, update your progress, and even receive art critiques in a supportive, friendly environment. Check out the link above to sign up today. I can't wait to see you there. Okay, so commission art versus fine art. This is a huge debate, and a lot of kind of like traditional fine artists are probably gonna crack the shits with me about what I'm gonna say, but I'm gonna be giving you guys a down low on what the difference is between the two and why I prefer one over the other. So it's my opinion based on my experience, but I thought I'd give you guys a little bit of knowledge about commission art, because I think there's a lot of prejudice against it in the art community, and it's a really awesome way to make a living off art. So that's what we're discussing today. So let's start off with what's the difference between the two things. Commission art is generally what I do. So I do a lot of commission and commercial art. So that's when the artwork hasn't been created yet and you're contacted by someone who's like, hey, cool artist, I really like your stuff. Can you please paint me a canvas or a skate deck or a mural or whatever? And this is what I would like on there. Or sometimes they can even say, you know, I want you to do whatever you want, which is awesome, but they're paying you to create something custom for them. That's essentially what it is. And with fine art, it's more like that you've created a body of work in your style and you're trying to sell that art that's already been created. So this kind of route would be a little more like, that you would contact galleries to try and get them to represent you. You would sell art and prints on your website. So you're putting your art out there and hoping someone buys it. So if you've been following along at home with my story and what I do, I am, like I said, commission commercial based artist. And there was a very good reason why I got straight into that. That's because I didn't actually start on my art journey until like a little bit later, I guess. I was a graphic designer and I'd been a designer for 10 years and I really, really hated it. And I'd always wanted to be an artist. So at 28, I finally had an idea of what I wanted to do, which was paint surfboards. And I was ready to like make the jump into fine art. There was two main things though. I didn't want to go back to waiting tables, which is what I used to do when I studied. And I didn't want to also be a graphic designer. So for me, it was really important that whatever arts career I went into, it had to make money and it had to be my breadwinner. So that was what was most important to me. So because of that, I moved into sort of commercial art, or what would you call it, commission-based art, because personally I find it much easier to sell art to people who want me to create art for them, if you know what I mean. Obviously sometimes I do sell finished pieces of art, but I find that you kind of have more power over your career if you can show a strong body of work, you know, this is what I do, and then people come to you and say, hey, can you paint a mural on my wall? Can you paint a skate deck? Can you do this? Can you do that? So as I said, I've been doing this for around 10 years now. I've managed to make it into a really, really cool career. I get paid to do my favorite thing in the world, which is paint. And one of the unintended bonuses that I didn't think about when I started is that when I started, I was pretty crap at painting and people paid me to get better at my craft. Like, that's insane. So now I have like a lot more really rad skills, and that was all paid for by my lovely clients. So yeah, that's a really helpful way of looking at it. In a nutshell, when we're talking about commission art versus fine art, I find that the fine art world with the traditional gallery model takes power out of your hands. You're relying on this middleman, which is the gallery, to find your clients, which normally, you know, they are pretty good at, but you have to be able to get a toehold into that first. They're taking a cut from all of your earnings in terms of commissions from the sales. It's a very antiquated system, I would say, and it, like I said, it's taking power away from you to be able to actively reach out to the people that you need to reach out to. Versus commission-based art, you can find your clients, and it doesn't rely on people looking at art that you have already and going, oh, well, that would be really nice if only it had a blue background or whatever. You can work with them directly to create something custom just for them, which I find is a really strong driver, and people will pay a really good amount of money for that service. Obviously, you can do a little bit of both. Most artists do tend to do a bit of both of those. Some artists hate doing commissions because they have to, you know, they want it to always be from the heart and be very much about them, and they don't want input from another person. Personally, I don't mind the client having input because sometimes they have really interesting or unusual ideas, or I get a chance to paint things that I normally wouldn't, which helps me level up my skills. Also, if you paint murals or street art, unless you get into, you know, graffiti, it's nearly impossible to be able to paint whatever you want on a wall because the wall is always owned by someone else. So they're normally going to have some input at least around what you can't paint on a wall. So, you know, it's not always possible to be able to just do whatever you want there. Anyway, guys, that's my thoughts on commission art versus fine art. If you disagree, or if you've got any amazing success stories using either model or both those models, please comment below. I would love to hear your feedback.